Namaste Shiva students, in today's computer video class I am going to show you how to format a document. So formatting means changing and arranging text in a document to make it attractive. When we are writing or typing any document or any writing in computer, we need to do it in an attractive way. So formatting is something that changing and arranging the text. We can format our document by font group and paragraph group in home tab. So these are the font group and this is the paragraph group. In font group you will see that many options are there. B for bold, I for italic, U for underline. If we want to bold or italic or underline any document, then we will click over here. Then here we will change the font type. This is font size. This is grow font, this is shrink font, and this is formatting or clear the font. So these are the few options. This is the changing of font color. This is changing of background of the font color. This small ABC, this is strike through, and this is the subscript, and this called superscript. So we can change different types of font in our document. Now as I am telling, changing the font, so we have to know what is font. Font is the shape and the look of any letter. Now come to the next topic, that is making text bold, italic and underline. To make the text bold, follow the given steps. Step 1, select the text you want to make bold. Click the home tab, click B, bold. From the font group, the text become bold. You can see after applying the bold, it will looks like this. Now to make the text italic, follow the given steps. Step 1, select the text. For every option you have to select the text first. Then you will click the home tab, then click italic I from font group. The text get italic. Next, to underline the text, follow the given steps. Step 1, select the text you want to underline. Click the home tab, click underline U from the font group. The text gets underlined. See here, text gets underlined. And what is the meaning of italic? It gets slanted. The text gets slanted after applying the italics. Now from page number 55, practical in computer lab, this practical question I will show you as an example of making bold, italic and underlined of text. Here you have to type the 3 lines about outdoor games that we all love to play. We have to write 3 lines about outdoor games. Now students, see, I have written 3 lines about outdoor game. This is the heading, outdoor game. The games that we play in the open air are called outdoor games. Outdoor games give us a chance to exercise our body and refresh our mind. Cricket, football, hockey are commonly known outdoor games in India. So this 3 line I have only typed with giving enter key and only presented over here. Now I will format this document. So how to do? First of all, this is the heading. So heading should be in the middle. So first I have selected with mouse dragging. Then I put. So we will go to the paragraph group and make it center aligned. This alignment I will read after showing this practical example. Then the game that we play in the open air are called as outdoor game. So I want to make this outdoor game as bold. So I am selecting the text, then click on font group bold tab. Now I just want to change the color. So for this I will go to font color and change the color of the text. I have chosen red color. See, that particular text become red. Now the next line, outdoor games give us a chance to exercise our body and refresh our mind. This outdoor game, this portion I want to make it italic. So I just select this outdoor game and go to font group and click on I. So see, you can see the changes. The text becomes slanted a little bit. You can put bold also. It will become much more dark. Then you can give underline also. So the text will get underlined by pressing the U tab. So this is how we can make our formatting of document. Now these are the some text name of the games that I want to highlight. So we can give bold as well as we can highlight the text. So hockey, football and cricket are commonly known as outdoor games in India. So in your book there has been not given so much thing about paragraph group, only font group given. The paragraph group will be taught you in the next class. Among them I have shown you the center alignment that I have given for this outdoor game to align it in the middle. So this is how we can do the formatting. Now in your book page number 55 it has been given that save the document in the name of games. So how to save a document? We have to click on the file tab, then go to save option. The save as dialog box appears. Type any name for your file. That file already given in your book, that is games. So you will type from the keyboard games, then you will save directly. The document is saving in document folder. Then you will click on the save button. Then the document automatically saved in document folder. And you see that in the title bar, the name has been changed as games. Whichever name you will save the document, the title bar will show that name. This is how we have to save any document. Now I will read saving a document. Your Word document is saved in the form of a file. It helps you to see it in the future. Step 1, click the file tab. Step 2, click the save option from the backspace view. The save as dialog box appears. Step 3, type any name of your file in the file name box. For example, my typing. Here I have given games. So this is how we can save. Now step 4. Click the save button. Word automatically adds a period dot and the extension docx to file name. Any file name saved with dot docx in MS 2010. For example, my typing dot docx. After the document is saved, the file name appears in the place of document title bar. So, whenever I saved any document, it will always take .docx as the extension. Underline this word extension. This is very important that Word document take the extension as docx. So, So hope you have understand how to do formatting and how to save any document. In this video class, I have shown a practical example of formatting and saving the document. So this is the end of the video class. Namah Shivaya.